So I'm Olivier Marlet and I come from Tours, Laboratoire Archéologie et Territoire in France. I will present you our experience using SIDOC CRM for dynamical querying parcel on the relational database from the semantic web. In all human sciences, the exponential increase in digital documentation requires us to question its management, its use, its availability to the scientific community, and its sustainability. In archaeology, these issues are particularly crucial because they're related to non-reproductible primary data. Long ago, we gave up the sterile debate about the possibility of adapting by the community of archaeologists of a single system that can respond to all situations and all needs. But faced with the multiplicity of systems and data structure, the question that arises is, are all systems interoperable? Fortunately, there are many points of convergence from one database to another. In other areas, particularly in medicine, several experiments show that the interoperability of information system can resolve this question without leading to a reductionist homogenization. The MASA consortium, MASA for Memory of Archaeologists and Archaeological Sites, approved by the TGR Humanum, large research cluster for digital humanities in France, gathers several performers in French archaeological research. One of its missions is to propose solutions to sustain and homogenize archaeological information. Within this consortium, the Laboratory Archaeology and Territories in Tours took on the task of working on the issue of the archaeological data interoperability. The objective is to develop unified access to digital corpuses using procedures and common tools for documenting and archiving. Sharing and particularly querying all archaeological data involves being relieved of the constraints of specific software, structure, vocabulary, accessibility, and language. The use of the SIDOC CRM ontology seems to be the most comprehensive model that can be used as a point of convergence for various archaeological databases. The goal is to enable researchers to make their system interoperable without changing the database structure that they are used to working with. To work on the interoperability, we have decided to work on the information system that we have been using for a long time at Tours, ARSOL, for Archive du Sol, Soil Archive. Initiated in This system has been developed with CatD software since 1990 for all the stratigraphic excavation with dual aims of data management and research. ARSOL is designed as a research tool both for recording and managing data during the excavation and for manipulating and exploring analysis of data during the post-excavation study, allowing us to shift the scale of analysis from intra to intersite. Therefore, ARSOL offers a complete processing chain allowing queries at different scales of analysis, those being essential assets for publishing with the ultimate aim of making evidence unquestionable. In addition, to be interoperable, a database must necessarily be available on the web. The ARSOL system has an online version allowing access to data from the web. So the ARSOL system is a valuable instrument to make various databases interoperable by using the SIDOC CRM ontology as a common foundation. Within the consortium MASA, we choose to use the SIDOC CRM since this is an international standard which structures the digital data for cultural heritage. Initiated in 1994, this ontology was originally designed for museums, but its scope is so broad that we can find most of the elements and properties specific to archaeological data. In particular, we find entity A22 man-made objects corresponding to artifacts and entity A25 man-made feature corresponding to the features. We see this ontology as a consensual description over layer through which the query can pass, allowing communication with each database thanks to a system of equivalence or mapping. The principle of these mappings is to match the entities of the ontology with the fields of the database. By using ontology, data become free from the database management system software and from the own database structure. Our project within the MASA consortium concerns French archaeology. However, database is truly interoperable if it becomes free from its vocabulary and language. The solution is to use a standardized multi-language thesaurus, which focuses on the concept and its strict definition more than vocabulary. PACTOL's thesaurus. PACTOLs for peoples, anthroponyms, timeline, places, names, works, places, and topics, widely used in human and social sciences, especially for the bibliography, is accurately faithful to the international standards for multi-language lingual theory and interoperability. ARSOL does not directly use the PACTOLs theory to describe artifacts or features, for example, but most of correspondences can be performed. For few elements present in ARSOL but absent from PACTOLS, work in, is underway with the Frontic Network team, which manages the thesaurus to extend the thesaurus with elements from ARSOL. To ensure a complete concordance, it's necessary to make a mapping between the terms of ARSOL and those used in ARSOL. Matching the vocabulary is an easy task. For ontology, this operation is called a mapping and consists in matching each field in the database with an entity of ontology respecting the whole hierarchical tree and the properties that organize the entities in the relation to each other. For ourselves, the first step is to map for the mapping is to select tables and fields that we want to query. To query ARSOL and to make it interoperable with other databases, we decided to select only tables containing basic information common to all excavations, features, and artifacts. The mapping of the table fait in ARSOL for feature and the table mobilier for artifacts. To the SIDEX ARM will provide access to the data from excavation stored in ARSOL, including documentation and datation. Then we need to appropriate the global model of the SIDEX ARM ontology to determine which the entity matches the most closely with the selected field in the database. This involves building the entire tree for positioning an entity within the model by specifying all intermediate properties and entities to precisely locate the specific entity. The next step is to write this entire tree by using RDF triples, Resource Description Framework. The triple subject predicate object becomes source entity, property, target entity. The target entity at the end of one branch is an element that must be associated with the field in the database. Okay. That field is collected in the mapping using a SQL query in the database. In the end, the whole file with these triples is a mapping file, of course, for each database with a specific structure, a different mapping is required. How can the ontology communicate with database using a mapping ASCII match? We choose to use NobiData systems for ontology-based data access. Recently introduced in the semantic web, which suits our needs. With this OBD layer, ontology is the access point to query the data, while the information remains in the databases used by the researchers. OBD system consists of an ontology, semantic level, here, a set of mapping expressing the relationship between the data source and the ontology, and the various data source here in your case ASL. We choose to use NTOP, this system, developed by Professor Calvanese and his team in the University of Bolzano. NTOP looks like an extension of Protégé, free software dedicated to ontologies developed in Java. It first allows us to specify the match between the ontology and database, then to evaluate Sparkle queries about ontology whose results are searched for in the database. Ontology is this is the OBDA file in NTOP. Ontology is loaded as an XML OWEL file. The data source is defined by indicating the query the driver to allow Java to communicate with the source database software to offer online query for web application, which is called Sparkle Endpoint. This is an example of a Sparkle Endpoint with the Sparkle query and the results in the Protégé software. Then what? Now we need to expand our number of data sources to give full meaning to interoperability. For this, we will do the same process with another archaeological database. Once this database has been chosen, we do some more mapping work, capitalizing on mapping already done for ASL, with the aim of producing a guide generic enough to enable the project that will follow the same path to unfold more efficiently. Then we'll need to define the software driver that allows Java to communicate with the selected software. This step should be repeated only if the type of source data source has not yet been included in the top system. It was a complex experience to make ASL interoperable, but we have developed a methodology directly reusable for other databases. The mapping file for ASL is obviously not reproducible for another database. However, the methodological work to implement this mapping is directly reusable for all the databases that we would like to integrate in the query system. This methodological work will help us to extend the experience with other archaeological databases within the consortium MASA. Now the effort will focus on the presentation of the presentation level. The Sparkle endpoint is essential for the web services that will query ASL, but we also have to allow humans to access ASL via the semantic level. So we will develop an application to manage web interfaces for users, an application that will use the Sparkle endpoint. Thank you.